Okay, so the subject that I've been given is making brands relevant for Gen Millennials. Before we start, and you know, after the kind words that Anantha had said, why are we kind of qualified to speak about what we are speaking? We as in my company called Vidgear, we work with brands like Samsung, WeChat, Maybelline, Pepsi, Lay's, and it's forced us to learn and unlearn everything there is to know. The average, I started my company at age 24, and the average age of people who work in my company is 24. We've got about 75 people working with us now. And so the average age of people, despite the fact that I'm well over 35, the average age of people working in our company is 24. So a new lesson is learned every day in marketing to the youth internally within our office when we have to implement new HR strategies and new things. I also like to keep my presentation short and crisp. There are six or seven things that we will talk about. I have one or two videos. I don't know if they'll play from this system, but we try them. So I've tried to pick up some youths, some myths, and talk about what are the things that I feel would make sense when we want to market to the youth. So the first part is connecting rather than reaching. This is also the subject of my chat. And you know, there will always be new ways of reaching out to the Gen Next. But you know, the Gen Next is, they don't want you to just reach out to them. They want you to connect with them. I don't know how much of this is repetition because I have not attended the sessions in the day. So pardon the repetitions. But the thing that I feel whenever we design any programs for the youth is that we have to get a way of connecting with them, not just reaching out to them, and connecting with them on a long-term basis where they become brand evangelists. They don't just become users, they also become your advertisers. They don't just buy, they sell as well. So there has to be a way, and I will keep repeating this in various other sessions, in various other slides, because this is what I believe in. Once you are able to connect with them, once you're able to create that emotional connect with the youth, that is when, you know, the magic happens. So it's not just about reaching out to them, it's not just about talking down to them, it's not just about informing them, it's about connecting with them. So this was a very interesting campaign from HP, where you know, HP is into prints, as we all know, and they wanted to reach out to the youth in a way that the youth would connect with them. And they did this very interesting campaign at a music festival. I'll just show it to you. I don't know if it's hyperlinked. No, it isn't. So we will have to minimize. And here we go. So they connected an HD camera to a ball and they got the youth to play with it at a music festival. So this is the kind of work that my company does. We are in the business of experiences. We provide experiences. We help brands reach out to their consumers in an interesting and innovative manner, not using the traditional media routes. I mean, there are media routes which are used, which are there to envelop an existing on-ground activity. So we create interesting experiences like this. And these are the kind of experiences that work with the youth. The next is about engaging and not educating. So it is all about engagement.
till the time we are not, see, the youth is, it's a different animal, as we say. I mean, as we, people who are above 35 say, it's a different animal. It's about engaging with them.
You know, if you're launching a new phone and you want them to know about the features, dude, they already know about the features the night it was launched, or probably before that. Probably before the features were out, they knew about it. So unless you engage with them, unless you do something, you know, you have a contest where you play with them, you get them to play with you. If you tell them this is 5 megapixel and this is so many GB and so many MB and so many TB, sorry, it doesn't work. It's not about educating them. It's not about telling them. They'll tell you more about your product than you want to tell them. Unless you are able to engage with them, they will not buy your product. So the second and most important thing is engaging with the youth and not educating them. So this was another interesting campaign. I forget the video. So where this was a very interesting campaign by Samsung, where they partnered with a company which does these obstacle races. And there was a long obstacle course, and a 16-kilometer obstacle course. At the end of the course, they created this huge washing machine. They wanted to sell the efficiency of the washing machines, and they got people to actually jump into the washing machine and clean themselves. So that is what engagement is. If they had said that our washing machine has a twin dry and a fuzzy logic and this, that, and the other, it would be educating them. They got them to experience it. They got them to get inside the damn washing machine and experience it. And that's how they engaged with the youth. Disrupt versus play safe. You need to disrupt. The days are gone where one can play safe and get results. If you expect results, you have to do them first, you have to do them better, you have to do them in a manner in which disrupts them. You know, I'm sure that there were a lot of people who were sleeping in this hall. Unless that microphone thing happened, they wouldn't have woken up. So one needs to disrupt whatever is happening in order for the youth to listen. And if there are any people in this room who are still sleeping, believe me, I'll get to you. Okay? So everything is very, very quickly forgotten, unless and until you do something which is disruptive. Stop them. You know, give them a pause in their life where they sit back and say, wow, what's happening? Whether that's good or bad, whether that spoils their ears because of a microphone noise, it doesn't matter. One has to disrupt. So this was a campaign which was done by my company about a year ago. Maybelline had launched a new lipstick. I'll take a minute in explaining this. Maybelline had launched a new lipstick which lasted for 14 hours, as opposed to the normal lipsticks which last for a few hours, I'm told. I don't have too much experience in that. But so they wanted something interesting. They wanted something which reaches out to the youth. We created a Twitter handle for them, hashtag what doesn't last long enough. So the hashtag said doesn't last long enough. And we asked women what doesn't last long enough. And there were, as expected, lots of interesting answers, cheeky answers. I won't get into what were the answers. But it was the highest trending hashtag on Twitter during that particular period. And we created it at Phoenix Mill, Bombay. To start with, we created a 14-foot high LED wall, which had a direct link with the Twitter feed, and all the Twitter messages which are coming were being relayed on this directly, and there was a 14-hour clock on top of it. And when this board got full of messages, it became in the shape of a Maybelline lipstick. So, you know, you get them curious, you get them involved, and they'll eat out of your hand. The next thing which I wanted to talk about was one versus many. The youth wants to be spoken to individually. They don't want to be spoken to as a community, as a group. No. If it connects with me, then I will listen to it. I am a unique individual, and we have to reach out to them and strike a chord with that individual person. If we speak to them as a demographic or as a category, it will not work. They will not be interested. So there has to be a one-to-one communication, and you will be able to turn them into brand evangelists. And that is the ultimate objective. So this is a very interesting campaign, which I really loved by Coca-Cola, which was done on Valentine's Day. I will again try to show you this video. Thank you. will come back. So one has to create these kind of experiences in order to connect with the youth. Going back to my presentation and trying F5 again from current slides. Yeah, it's worked this time. The next thing which I was wanted to speak about was interconnect versus dead ends. When one markets to the youth, there has to be a link, there has to be a chain. It can't just stop at a particular thing, that I created a branded pamphlet and gave it to them and it stops at that. There has to be a chain of things, there has to be a linking. You know, you would be surprised at how connected the youth are. So there is something that you give them, which they post on Twitter, which is carried on Facebook, which, you know, comes back on their mobile. So there has to be a chain, there has to be no dead ends. The minute a dead end comes, you stop marketing to the youth. So there has to be a series of things. There has to be. So we are the thread, and there are various needles, which is the youth. Unless and until we are able to go around in all those needles, we are not successful marketeers to the youth. So there's always something happening with their phone. There's always something happening with their laptop. There's always something happening in their life. They're multitaskers. They're doing five things at the same time. So unless and until you tie up all the loose ends, It should not come to a dead end where they saw a campaign and they finished and they forgot about it and that was the end of it. If you are able to carry it through to different mediums, to different sources, then you'll be successful to market to the youth. Okay, I won't show this video. There are too many videos happening. But this was another very interesting campaign where Ben and Jerry's created this tour. They took this truck and They got the youth to invite them to different places, to their colleges, where they set up a small carnival kind of thing, give them ice cream and everything. And it was integrated over various mediums, social media, mobiles, apps, of course, television, hoardings, radios, and it became a huge campaign. We need to have fun with the youth. We take ourselves too seriously. Unless and until they are amused by what you're doing, they will not stand up and take notice. So humor always works. Be funny, be quirky, make fun of yourself. It's all right. But in order to reach out to the youth, you can't be as serious as we are. So have fun. If you're having fun, they will have fun. They will like you. And that will begin a conversation. That's what we have to do, right? We have to begin conversations. So we have to create things which engage, which are fun, which begin conversations. This I would like to show. This was a very interesting youth-related activity which was done, and this is my last video. Okay, so I think you've got the picture. Would you like to see more? So the cab keeps running as long as you keep talking. Disruptive. So that's what I call disruptive. That is what I call engaging, and that is how one reaches out to the youth.
Okay.
Next thing which I want to talk about, number six and the second last, is experiences versus logos. I know that sounds a little confusing. You know, when brands reach out to the youth through festivals, through concerts, through different mediums, the youth want to experience them. They don't just want their logo stuck there that, you know, this institute has sponsored this particular event. You know, if you look at, for example, the NH7 which happens in Bacardi, the association goes much beyond the logo. The association is when you live the brand. If the youth will become evangelists when they see you passionate about what you're doing. So if Nike just sponsors a marathon, it's one thing. If Nike takes part and makes sure that the marathon runners are, you know, in the best shape, or marathon runners are trained, or whatever it is, that is when the youth will catch on. So one doesn't have to create just logo presence. One has to create experiences which are innovative and interactive. So this was a particular experience where Adidas, Adidas had created these radios for a music festival, and it was a hugely appreciated campaign. And finally, loyalty versus money. You see, if you create one transaction that just converts into one sale, what we are buying from the youth is their loyalty. Once they are loyal consumers, they are there for life. So what is most important is one has to connect with them in such a way that one creates a loyal brand of consumers, and they will be with you forever and ever. That is my presentation. There was another interesting case about HBO and their Game of Thrones. And the final slide, which is youth no longer is a demographic, it's a mindset. So I still consider myself as part of the youth. Thank you very much.